So that last lick is actually part of a monster lick. Like I said, I was doing Crimson and the Clover, and I was laying on, I think it was a four note, whatever it was. But the monster lick started down here with an arpeggio. Like, you know, I like to do reverse arpeggios. And then, you know, my famous second strings. And then... And when I got up to here... Go down to the three and then bend up to the one on the second string. The three on the fourth string. Bend up to the one on the second string, and then do your, get your finger ready. Whoops. So all together, slowly, it's going to be like this. You know, this is a recliner shape. And then a pull off with the cascade shape. And then a L shape. Something like that. So you get the picture. But this happens to be in the key of D sharp. As the neighbors got the front door open and across the street, the windows open, might be able to hear me in the apartments, but actually there's a number one. That was a number one arpeggio. Okay, Crimson and Clover. Whatever notes those are, but that's a one. To there. To a four, a one, one, five, five, four, four. Okay, so three, four, five, six, seven, one. So I can get all those memorized. I gotta keep counting, man. So it is a 1-4-5 right there. That landed on the one. Stuff. So that's that. Talk to you later. That's what you call a monster lick. I learned that name from Frank Gamble, the jazz guitarist. You know, he was all on in the magazines when I was growing up. You know, he'd have all these books with names of scales that have exotic names. Man, you can't even pronounce them. Anyway, it's on the public record now. So. See you later.